Hello and welcome to this tutorial on creating prefabs from code in runtime, hoping it will fasten your creation and storing process. Here I had opened a previous project of mine, a random maze generator with random width and length. The maze generator creates a new maze when I press new maze button. It is a new game object holding the borders of the maze named as maze, width and length. And if I have no ways to store the maze, it is gone till next time it appears randomly. I can create the prefab as always by dragging the object from hierarchy to project folder. This cuts the speed of creating and saving the mazes though. So adding a new button to screen and connecting it is onclick event to prefab source fastens things. When the button is pressed, we get new prefabs created from a randomly created maze on the scene. After that, you can decide on which one to use or not. Tell you the truth, code is very simple and straightforward. I will be making the save code from maze generator using save maze function, but you can give this responsibility to a separate class and call it from there. The implementation goes as follows and is from the implementation example from IntiDocs, which will be linked in the down in the descriptions. First, creating a local path. Starting with folder path, we need to confirm that this path exists, otherwise we get object not found error and no prefabs. After folder path, naming the prefab. We will be using the name of the target object to be stored and lastly adding the file type .prefab to our path. Our path is ready, but there will be existing prefabs with the same name. To make our prefab unique, we call assetDatabase.generateUniqueAssetPath with our local path and set the return value to local path. For example, if we already have a prefab called maze in our prefabs folder, but we are trying to save a prefab called maze again, this gives an index to it as maze1 and saves like that. A good way to dodge errors or unexpected outcomes. Now we have our unique path. Let's save the game objects as a prefab there. We will be using prefab utility.save as prefab asset and connect function and provide the path information, target game object to save as prefab, and lastly the interaction mode of our action. Interaction mode is about letting developers undo an action applied to Unity editor. Using user action, we are allowed undo action. For details, I will be linking the documentation page. With that, we are ready to save the prefab from maze generator. If we opt for creating a save manager, we can create one with the same approach, giving it reference to the game object to be saved as a prefab and the same process as the save maze generation from maze generator. Create local path. Make local path unique. Save the game object as prefab. It will be up to you how you want to save a game object as prefab, by putting the responsibility in class or dividing between classes. With that, this is the end of this tutorial. Before finishing up, I want to tell you where this came from. Maze generation is a written tutorial of mine, and when I published it, I was also looking over posts about maze generation. There was one comment on, there are tutorials creating things, but none of them tells how to save them. After that, I looked around how to create a prefab from an object in runtime and found this approach in documentation. So here we are. I will be linking the doc pages and the tutorial for maze generation. Hope this will be helpful in your projects, and if there was a point not clear, please let me know in the comments down below. And if you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe for the future ones. That's it for now. I hope to see you in the next explorations, and bye bye!